Nero here from TPLA. You might know me from some of the videos on our channel, especially the Weapons Locker reviews or some of my Makashi work. I previously did a Weapons Locker review on the Vader's Vault Revan. You can see it here on the table. It's one of my favorite hilts. Still going strong. I'm a big fan of that. If you watch that, you'll kind of know what my thoughts are on some of the features of the electronics, the crystal shard soundboard, all that jazz. Definitely a big fan of that whole setup that Vader's Vault does with their installs. So it kind of leads you into today's weapon locker, which is actually on a newer design that they came out with. Recently they had some experience with the Saber Legion, the dueling group for lightsaber enthusiasts. And they decided that they would make a hilt design that's a little bit less style-based and a little bit more intended for combat. All their combat class generally is covered for dueling, but this one was designed so that the ergonomics and aesthetics were kind of more in line with what the people in that tournament use. So anyway, long story short, they came out with some models ready to ship because they needed, the initial prototypes and all that. I decided that I was intrigued by it. There were a lot of different customization options that they had explored. One of them in particular caught my interest, so I got it. And just to see what it was like and get a sense of if I might like it. Anyway, here it is. This is the Vader's Vault Legionnaire. This is the shadow version, which has the black powder coating, and it also has a dark blue powder coating on different accents. The emitter here, the diamonds, and the pommel. It's a really nice combination. This is probably my ideal combination for this saber, being as it's nice and subtle. The black is a nice matte black. The blue is, there's just enough there so that it's not overdone, but it's a nice accent against the black and silver. I'm a big fan of the way they powder coated it in particular. The saber itself, as far as ergonomics go, it's very comfortable. It's about 14 inches in length, so definitely leaning towards a two-handed style. You could use it one-handed. It's very well balanced and all that. Obviously, very capable for any type of combat, but I definitely prefer to use the longer hilts with two hands in particular. I save the one-handed stuff for my shorter hilts, like the Revan and whatnot. Other than that, the diameter is actually quite similar to the other combat class. I have my Revan here just to give you a point of comparison. You can see it's quite a bit longer, but it's also very similar in diameter. So it has that slim design that Vader's Vault hilts are known for their combat class at least. I haven't really experienced any of the others. That's about all there is to it. It's a good solid combat saber. Like I said, you kind of already know how I feel about the Crystal Shard if you've seen the Revan review. Big fan of that board. It has great responses, up to 6 sound fonts, great sound quality, just a good all-around soundboard for someone like me who kind of doesn't need all the features of a Crystal Focus or Igniter, but wants high quality sound. So anyway, I'll show you a little bit of it lit up. This is actually a heavy grade blade that I'm using. I find a heavy grade blade works particularly well with this saber for various reasons. First off, the length, and I guess probably the suba, gives it a little more weight in the hilt, which kind of makes it balance really well with the heavy grade. Makes it not too blade heavy, but just gives it enough weight in the blade for presence. So you can kind of see it balances a couple inches up from the emitter with the heavy grade blade. This is actually cut down. I think this is a 34 inch heavy grade or something, but it would probably be perfect with any size. I'd say 34 to 36 inches for heavy grade. This one has a Tri-Cree blue, BBW, I believe it is. So it's just a nice, powerful, you know, pretty blue color with a nice silver flash on clash. Distinctive Imperial Knight sound font. Changes I made to it when I got it were I added a couple sound fonts on my own. I changed some of the settings because I find that Vader's Vault Sabers tend to be a little more sensitive than I like when I get them. The swings and whatnot, so I tweaked a few of those to give them a little less sensitivity so it wasn't going off quite all the time. But it's still very, very responsive and just where I like it right now. Sound fonts are great. Like I said, up to 6 sound fonts you can put on there. Great quality and all that. No issues there. And that's really about it. I guess no big negatives. I think the only negatives for the saber, there is a threaded portion here, which I'm sure is necessary for the install. It's not very easy to come undone, but it definitely will come undone if you put a little bit too much torque on it, which if you're using this for combat, you probably will. Not a big deal, as long as you don't keep unscrewing it, as long as you keep aware of that fact. But yeah, a one-piece hilt obviously has its drawbacks, but also it doesn't have that issue of coming apart. I think the only other negative I can think of is more of a subjective one. Some people don't love this design because it's not as Star Wars-y. It's a little more of a traditional katana look instead of a lightsaber look, something more like, you know, the Revan or other character hilts. That's just something that's going to vary from person to person. It's not an objective knock on the saber. It's just a dividing point. Some people will like it because it's a nice ergonomic dueling hilt, and some people won't because it doesn't call to them as a Star Wars weapon. It's fine. Anyway, I'm very pleased with it. I think it's a great two-hander. I think it's a fun hilt to wield, very comfortable, very customizable with all the powder coating details on this, and the options they provide between the accents and the shadow versus silver. A lot there to customize. You can actually remove, if you unscrew this, the suba. So some people don't love the suba, but they like the saber. They remove it. No big deal. I like it. It's fun. It's a good saber to wield. I've had good results with it thus far. But anyway, I wanted to let somebody else have a say in the matter so that I'm not the only one blabbing on. So he's going to fill you in on the rest and his opinions on the saber, and I'll catch you next time.
Thanks, Nero. Okay, well, first impressions of this are interesting looking. Let's put it through some combat.